Then next ayat talks about the Bani Israel, going back. Okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is reminding an agreement, a covenant that He made with the Bani Israel. Okay? And it happened in the past. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding by saying, what is? Is means when. When sometimes in the past. So what is and when. When in the past, there was a time in the past where something happened. Okay? Now, next word is starts with these three letters, Alif, Ha, and Zal. One meaning is to take. Okay? So, if we have these three letters, Fa and Lam, this means to do. Okay. And if you put a na at the end, it becomes fa'al na. Fa'al na means we did. Past tense and first person plural, we. Okay. So that's how we make the past tense and plural first person. Fa'al na. So this word will be akhadna. If you do the same thing, akhadna means we took. Okay. So if we do the same thing, wa id akhadna, we took. Past tense and first person plural. Now who is here we? We is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning about something that happened in the past, and He is saying that we took, means Allah took. Wa idh akhazna, and when we took. Okay. Now the word after that is misaq. Misaq is an agreement between two parties. Misaq is a covenant or agreement between two parties. So here one party is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the other party is Bani Israel, children of Israel at the time of Musa alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that in the past sometime we took an agreement, we made an agreement. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Bani Israel made an agreement or a covenant. So, وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا, and when we made or we took a covenant, which means an agreement between two groups, two parties. And who is that agreement was made with? Bani Israel, children of Israel. Okay? So, it will be with or from children of Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made an agreement or a covenant with the Bani Israel. So now the next few words are what are the different parts of that are covenant or agreement. So the first one is La ta'buduna illallah. That's the first one. Okay, so here it starts with Ayn, Ba and Dal, Abada, this means to worship. Okay, so if we put a Ta in the beginning and Guna at the end, and leave the middle three letters, ta'abuduna, this means you, plural, will worship. This is present tense or past tense grammar. When you put a ta in the beginning and buna at the end, it becomes the you, plural, all of you, and present tense or future tense. So here future tense will be you will worship. Okay? Ta'buduna. Ta'buduna means you will worship. And if you put a la in the beginning, it will be you will not worship. Negative. Okay? So the misal is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying la ta'buduna, you will not worship. So that's the part of the agreement. You will not worship. Then the word is illa. Illa means except. Illa means except. Except Allah. So the agreement was you will not worship anyone except Allah. Okay? Means only and only your Lord to worship will be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. So this is rejecting completely that you will not commit any shirk. You will not associate anyone in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ta'buduna illallah. You will not worship anyone but only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that was the topmost part of the mithaq, the agreement. That you are worshipping will only be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Then, the next part of the mithaq is, these are the three letters, and walidun means father, and if walidatun means mother. Walada means to be born or to have a child or someone. Okay. Well, we just learned that if you put in alif, it becomes the doer. So in this case, walidun means father. And when we put a ta at the end, it becomes feminine. Walidatun. Okay. So it's a one father and one mother. The plural of these two words is walidain. Walidain means parents. Okay, father and mother both. Okay? So that's the word in the Quran. Wabil walidain. Okay? So B is a harf. Okay, B means with. And it's a harf jar, so it will make it walidaini. With the parents. Al walidain, the parents. B means with and with the parents. Okay? So sum up combination of these is walidain. Then you put a B means with. And al means da. And bil walidaini and with the parents. And with the parents. Then the next word starts with this letter, ha, seen, noon, and this means to be good or to do good.
Hasana.
Yeah, hasana. Okay. And ihsan means goodness. Ihsanun means good or goodness. Ihsan is some good action. Okay. So what is it saying? Wabil walidaini ihsana. And you will be good with the parents. Okay. you will not. So right after the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is do not associate any partner with Allah, worship only one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next important thing is here, be good to your parents. Okay? Wabil walidaini ihsana, and good with the parents. So be good with parents. The next word is Qaf, Ra, and Ba. This means to be near.
Qareeb.
Qareeb, yes. Qaraba, Qarabat, Qurbat, those are the words. Okay. Dhil Qurba means near relatives. Qurba means some which is close. Dhil Qurba, those who are close. So for the near relatives, the word is used as dhil qurba, those near to you in relationship. Okay. So this is after the parents. The next category is with all other relatives who are blood relative to you, or close relation to you in the family. So be good to the parents and be good with the relatives. Okay. And
so wazil qurba is one word.
Zi means, you know, it's called na wale. Kareeb wale. Zi means that's it. Zi means those who. Okay. Qurba means near. So and dil qurba and those near, or so you can say near relatives.
Immediate family.
Right, immediate family. Well, more than immediate family. Okay, like uncle and aunts and grandparents, all is included in there. Anything who comes part of the relationship in the family. The dhil qurba. Okay? Near relatives. Okay? And then the next word is wal yatama, and the orphans. Okay, these are the words which are commonly used. And the orphans. So be good to the orphans. Okay. And the next word is masakin, which is the plural of miskin. Miskin means needy person. So masakin, needy people. Okay. These are common words. I'm not going into details. And the needy. Those who are in need are called masakin. So these are all the parts of the agreement that was done between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Bani Israel.
But this was in Torah?
This is in Torah. Okay. And then after that is waqulu linnasi husna. Okay. So qaf, waw and lam means to say, okay. And kulu means say, kulu means say or speak, it's a command. Wakulu is an order, say. Okay, so when you talk or you speak to linnasi, okay, so let's look at the word nasun means people. Nasun means people. It's a plural. The actual word is insun. Insun means one person. Insun means one person. Like insan. They're from the same root letters. And its plural is nasun, means pupil. Okay? And if I put al before that, it becomes the pupil. Okay? And when you put al, one of these two dhammas change into one. And it becomes al nasu. But noon is a shamsi letter, so it gives the sound of lam and pronounced annasu, the pupil. Okay? Annasu, the pupil. Okay? And if you put a letter lam with a kasra, it means two. To the pupil. Now what happens when you put this lam with a kasra? Two things happen. This is a harf jar, so it changes this lam, this dhamma into a kasra. And then you do not pronounce this alif here. Okay. So you combine lam with the lam. Okay, and that lam was not pronounced already, so it becomes linnasi. The to the pupil.
Pehle wo do dhamma change hua one mein, right? Mm-hmm. Ab one change ho gaya
kasra mein. Because of this li.
Okay.
Li is a harf jar. Mm-hmm. It changes the last dhamma into kasra.
Okay.
Okay. So the word becomes separately. This word is li. Al nasun. Originally it was nasun. Okay? Al changed two dhammas into one. So it will become al nasu. But in pronunciation it becomes an nasu. Then you put a lam with a kasra. And his has a separate meaning which means two. And that changes dhamma into a kasra. So, and this alif is not pronounced now, so it becomes linnasi. Linnasi means to the pupil. Okay?
Noon become mushaddad. Noon become mushaddad.
Yeah. Because of this, yeah. So, waqulu linnasi, and say to the pupil, or speak to the pupil. And speak to the pupil what to speak to the pupil? Husna, good. So when you talk to the people, be good to them. Okay? Do not be arrogant, do not be rude, do not hurt them. Okay? Be nice, be good to them when you speak to them. Okay? And speak to the people good. Okay. So that was another part of the Nisaq.